thank you for everything that you are to many of us.
You cannot go to this. That is not where I told you to stay.
I cannot see anything from back.
And one of the photographs will start with
you. People are top past me now.
Before the rest of the protocol. Thank you very much.
Yes. So I have been assigned the task of taking beautiful pictures in like 3 minutes. So I'm going to very quickly call.
That they call the cake will go from here now. Don't call the cake now. You are not here before now. Let us call the cake. We'll go. We cannot do if we go back like that. After the cake, we'll leave here now.
After the cake, we need to leave here.
Like this, Don't climb that place, so stay down.
Let them go down.
Sleep for
sale. State, Governor Akinwumi Ambode, and his wife, and economic development of Lagos State, we can only say thank you. After many good jobs, it's more work. After beautiful challenges, it's more success. If you work hard at it, we are in the boat together. Your Excellencies, various governors, all of the governors from Leather, across the country, Kano, Kebbi, Kaduna, Imo, Igawa, the diversity of Nigeria, all of you, the governors, thank you. All the deputy governors, and particularly the idiot of Lagos State, thank you for the friendship and the collaboration with your governor. Because I can look back and see how it is. The honorable ministers, some former governors, and today ministers, all of you have to really invest most important assets of humanity, time, in celebration and understanding the discussion of investing in people. I say thank you very much. Ministers, Alayeluwas, and my very tough father, Olowoko, Baba Fuad, thank you on your favor. From far and wide, from the north, from the east, from west, as also your royal fathers, I thank you very, very much. My family, my dear wife, thank you very much. You are the comment of Mr. President. Thank you for tolerating me. As if you have any choice. To my extended family, the Speaker, House of Lagos House of Assembly, and other speaker. Yeah. I could see some of my very faithful friends and compatriots over the years, my advisors, my brothers, my friends. Aliko Dangote. Dimovia, about Tunep, our hopes. I'm just lost for words. And thank you. And the political sponsors and followers who have been supporting us over the years. Thank you very much. Yes, when we came in with a whole lot of hope as APC leaders. Several discussions with diplomatic corps, with foreign dignitaries, put a hedge together, thinking and believing in ourselves that we can change Nigeria for good. We were strongly determined that we will. We gave our people the confidence and the hope. We believe in ourselves. We believe in Nigeria. And we're still going to do it. Life is not interesting without challenges. We didn't come with political parties showing our logo as honey and sugar. Our logo is a broom, bunched together, united Nigeria, focuses against terrorism, against corruption, and promotes economic revival of the country. We could see in real life, investing in people. I have a speech here. From what I've seen here, I just have to abandon it. And talk to it. I can see what the government is doing with so little. But the idea, the fact that they're doing it, the fact that they are beneficiaries, the fact that it is demonstrated in practical terms, is what we need to get our country from the throes of corrupt officers. Ah, they said, don't talk about it. Ah, what should we talk about? That we came in to play chess, we saw your thievery and stealing and looting. We say, okay, you can continue the same way. Let's join you. It's because we're against you. We won't encourage you. And if we are not talking about it, then what is the lesson to all Nigerians? Forget those parties. They won't come back. No nation without its challenges. Even America is facing challenges. Not about our, how many years of democracy? We did say we will not be challenged. But we have to report to millions of Nigerians voting for us that this is what we find, and we are not going to take it off the ground, no matter how twisting the mind of PDP and their supporters may be. We keep talking about it. You looted. You wasted our resources. You did not do what you promised. The market gave you the maximum. The production level was at the maximum. And there's nothing. Yoruba says, I did the only, only sala. Thank you, Nigerians, for being patient. Be patient with us. There's a clear understanding here. There's a difference between us and them, night and day. I want the economic minister to please give us a data. First quarter of 2012, and for the 16 years. I remember my grandmother used to send me to a letter writer in the post office of those days, and near the magistrate court. So somebody who's writing letters these days, the letter of politics. The voyage is on, the voyage of hope, the voyage that we are reclaiming Nigeria, we are retooling Nigeria, we are reinventing Nigeria, we are redirecting Nigeria. It's not an easy course to embark upon. Dear Nigerians, don't take the apology. They lied, they falsified, they changed figures. For 16 years, they made fake promises, give us fake figures, and they say, don't talk about it. It's like saying, after you caught a thief, he said, don't look at me, go and steal your own. We're not taking that. We're soldiering on. We have a nation to rescue. We have a good leader to emulate. We have hope. We have hope to give. We have belief, and we have people to invest in. That's what we must do. Credit is available. As we grow that credit, what happens? Once credit is available, that is anti-corruption. If our credits are open, and people need a car, they don't have to pay 4 million cash at the same time. Jimovia, you better think about this. I'm promoting more credit for this economy. So not that your credit, my credit card is not available, but it should be more available digitally and to take small incomes, extend loans, that will stimulate this economy. We don't have to pay for a house of 10 million same day, same month with cash. Once you can give us credit, tie it to mortgage. Yes. And we can pay instrumentally. We have reduced the propensity for corruption. Mr. President, join me with you. We're going to work on the strengthening the pension plan to stimulate growth and this economy. I promise you a paper I will come up with. I will work harder quickly because you spend your time here today. Thank you very much for your encouraging us. Yes, no, every clear Nigeria, every thinking Nigeria, we know that there are challenges. But what are we doing about it? And we must articulate those programs, make a promise to Nigerians once again that hope is back. We have the audacity of it. We will bring Nigeria on the right path of prosperity and banish poverty forever. Thank you very much.